Well, let's go on a different tack now. We've talked about all different three areas, but let's talk about some place where I've spent a lot of time and where I know probably people that are listening to this wanna talk about, and that's building wealth and creating abundance of money. What kind of spiritual What's our spiritual path to developing abundance of wealth?
Actually, I think it's not very different from being healthy and also from getting the best relationships. I think there are certain, it's like three different meals, each one being great, but there might be a preference for one over the other ones. And I, who came from a family of 12, imagine that. I'm the eldest son of 12 children.
Oh yeah, I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And it was in a little farming and fishing village where it was really tough to make a living. And I'm the first one who went to high school, who went to college, and one of the very few who left to get an education overseas. It was amazing how that went from a little village to today. And it's no different with wealth, because in those days, a penny was a lot of money, a quarter was a lot of money, and I imagine a lot of us could tell those stories. But it was a feeling that if I wanted to do all the things I need to do, there will be an influx of the ways to do it, the money to do it. Now, many times I found that, yes, I could sit down and plan the greatest strategy on earth, and I've done that and made a lot of money out of it. But with that comes a kind of a, also, let's say a burden. A burden. I remember living in, it was a 10,000 square foot house. That was a big house. That was a beautiful thing, custom built, almost 100,000 gallon swimming pool at the back. And that's the one, by the way, where Richard Bach and I and his wife had dinner. And I remember thinking, look at all these beautiful things. There's a lot of money. I don't have to worry about that. But all through it, there was a kind of a sadness. I would be sitting in the jacuzzi in the pool, and I would be way before cell phones, would be talking to a counterpart in Africa in one of those giant portable phones. Many people would know the time when those didn't exist. And yet there was this sadness. I'd stand by, look at the moon, look at the skies, and said, John, why aren't you as happy as the proverbial hog, so to say? And I couldn't understand why, because I had, here's the difference, I had everything to live with, nothing to live for. And so maybe that's one of the reasons I created the situation which caused me to lose all of that to find myself again. And so if we want, money is not bad. Never have I thought so. In fact, I think money is very important. And if somebody tells me that money is not important, I'd wonder what else they'd lie about, because it's up there in importance with things like air and food and so forth. So it's important, but it's a tool. It's a tool. It's God in action, if you will. And it helps us do some of the most marvelous things we can do. Take, for example, because of your affluence and your abundance, I have always admired this about you, but I knew it about you even before you knew that I knew. You think of somebody in the Make-A-Wish Foundation, who's and quite a number of them, whose dreams were fulfilled because you exist. If you were working, making $20,000 a year, would you have been able to make that possible for a bunch of kids? Take for example, take again your contributions to so many charities like Toys for Tots and so many others I don't even know about that you don't even tell people about because of the special guy you are. But because of your wealth, you have been able to help a lot of people change their lives. I have never known you as the guy who says, I gotta get, and I can't give because if I give, I will have less. You have unconsciously, or maybe consciously, used one of the methods of amassing wealth, and you can. You don't only have to amass millions. If you so choose, you're one of the guys I will bet on. You could make billions. I don't know what you do with it, and you might be bored with that too. But one of the things you do is you give it away so it comes back to you 10 to 100 times. People who in your field of internet marketing don't realize that. They're looking at, how can I get this affiliate system going? How can... Now, those are important things too. But I think more important than that is to get to the point where the focus is not totally on how much I'll get. I think the focus should be, what will I give to get how much I want? And many times it's you give a service or you give a product, and you create those because people need them, and you're divinely inspired to do that, which is what you did starting with Instant Sales Letter. You gave a tremendous product to the world, and they thank you. Thank you for it. You know how they thanked you? Just like I asked Richard Bach once. I said, Richard, and he and I had conversations that were stranger than things we wrote in our books. I said, Richard, what is the secret of money, having made so much and lost it all too, and then got it back? He says, John, the secret of making a lot of money is this. Give your gift as beautifully as you can to the world, and the world would say thank you. And I thought, oh, that's what I asked this great man about, and this is what he says. The world will say thank you. Man, I'd be a multimillionaire if I banked all the thank yous people give me. I said, come on, Richard, that's it. He says, you didn't let me finish. Here is how the world says thank you. They send you cash. Now I started thinking, how do they do that, may I ask? He says, well, let me give you an example. We were broke. We had gone through bankruptcy, and we were almost starving, but then we put together a book called Bridge Across Forever. It was our gift, and we sent it out to the world. It was the best we could do, and the world said thank you by buying my book. And every time someone bought my book, there was a little bit added to another little bit someplace, and before you know it, we were out of our poverty. That's how we make this money. So in the internet area, and, you know, I watch what goes on. I get a gazillion newsletters from everybody selling something, that this is the best thing in the world, and you got to get this. And those are good things, except that the purpose behind them, the intent behind them, are not. It's like most people are thinking, well, let's see if I could put this thing together, and if I could force it to get to 100 people to buy it, and they all make $100 from each one, that will be $10,000. That'll be great. I think most people could do it by stepping back a little bit and looking at what they want and creating a system to bring them the money they want than just shooting for the money. One other comment on that, Yannick. Many years ago, after I had lost everything, I met a wise old man, a top psychic, and he looked at me and he said, you know, John, you will make all the money in the world that you want, whether that be $1,000 or $100,000 or $1,000,000, you will make all the money in the world that you want to make when money is not as important as it is to you right now. What he was saying was, at that time, I had hypnotized myself to thinking that I couldn't do anything. The most important thing I needed to do was to make money. And so in your field, there are a few people who teach good things and the way to deal with it. And yes, the mechanics are important. One has to know what an affiliate system is before he or she starts really doing it properly, and then honing one's skill like a musician does or a martial arts teacher does.
Let me just jump off on something else then. Well, actually going back, I mean, what you talked about was, to me, there's one of my core values that I always look at is I'm gonna get rich by enriching people 10 times to 100 times what they pay me. And that's something that I try to look at every single day. It's been a guiding principle since I started, and that really is my core belief, that you can't over deliver value without the universe rewarding you. And I think that's similar to what you said.
Yeah, that's the main secret, I think. If you were to think of all the people you have met in this internet world, Yannick, you will find that maybe 5% might think that way. And there are so many others who go after the thing. They just give a product because they want to get the money. And your core value, your belief in this, fulfills one of the greatest laws of affluence, laws of the universe. And that's why you prosper and you will always prosper.